morning students, Sairam. Welcome back to our science period. Children, now which one is going on? Our revision is going on for your first semester, isn't it? So this session I am going to take revision on chapter number 15, life process in living organism. Okay, last session we had studied about, yes, control and coordination. Introduction only we revised. Then I am going to take revise of coordination in plants. Okay children, plants do not have systems like the nervous system or muscular system of animals. So animals are having nervous system and muscular system with coordination. Okay, but plants do not have these systems. In plants, movement are mainly in the form of responses given to the stimuli. You know very well what is meant by stimuli, isn't it children? Next one is, see here, trophism or trophic movement. See that movement, what is meant by trophism? Movement or growth of any part of the plant in response to an external stimulus is called trophism or trophic movement. See here children, yes, that movement of growth of any plant to an external stimulus, it may be sunlight or water or other chemicals or gravitational force. Okay, that kind of movement is called what? Trophic movement. Okay, now we will see about growth relevant movements. So one by one we will see. First one is phototrophic movement. Photo means, you know, that is light, isn't it children? Photo means what? Light. The shoot system, that means the tip region of the plant. So you know the tip region of the plant, where it will go? It will grow towards the sunlight. So the shoot system of any plant responds to the light stimulus. Okay, that means it grows towards the source of light. This kind of movement is called what? Phototrophic movement. Okay, shall we go to next one now? So now we will discuss about growth relevant movement. See here, here sun. So sunlight is coming like in this direction. So towards the sunlight, this plant will grow. Okay, shall we go to next one now? Next one is gravitrophic or hydrotrophic movement. You know that gravi means here what? Yes, gravitational force, and hydro means water. The root system of plants responds to stimuli like gravitation. Okay, that means gravitational force. You know the root, it will grow towards the under the earth, that means towards the gravitational force and water. So these responses are called what? Gravitrophic movement and hydrotrophic movement. So what is meant by gravitrophic movement? Yes, the root system of plants responds to the stimuli like gravitation and water. Towards the gravitation stimuli, that is called gravitrophic movement. Towards the water, that is called what? Hydrotrophic movement. Next one is, see here, movement shown by plants in response to specific chemicals. Okay, that is called what? Chemotrophic movement. So towards some particular, that movement is called what? Chemotrophic movement. So example, the growth of the pollen tube towards the ovule. See here, the next slide I have shown this. Yes, see this diagram children. Yes, this is ovary. Okay, this is ovary and here ovule is there. Here some specific chemical is there. So when that after the pollination, yes, that pollen tube will grow from the pollen grains. Okay, towards the ovule, because inside the ovule which one is there? Specific chemicals. So that pollen tube will grow towards the chemical. So this movement is called what? Here movement is there, isn't it children? So this movement is called chemotrophic movement. I hope you understood this one. Shall I go to next one now? Next one is, see here, thigmotrophism. This theory part is there, theory part is not there in your textbook, but diagram is there. Okay children, see here, the growth movement in plants in response to a touch stimulus or contact with the solid object known as thigmotrophism. Okay, once again I'll read. The growth movement in plants in response to a touch stimulus or contact with the solid object is known as thigmotrophism. For example, in some plants, The coiling of tendrils. Have you seen that tendrils? Yes, in some creepers plants that tip region, that is, it is curly. That means it is coiling of structure. Okay, that is called what? Tendrils. So the tendrils occur when they come in contact with object to support. So that tendril will take support from the solid object. So afterwards it will grow. Okay, so that moment is called what? Thickmotropism. Okay, children, see here. Yes, this is the tendrils. Okay, this is tendrils, and when this one will take support from the solid object, okay, to grow. Shall I go to next now? So children, see here, all the above mentioned movements of plants are related with growth. Okay, phototropism, hydrotropism, gravitropism, and chemotropism and thickmotropism. So this all movement, it is, yes, it is related with growth of the plants. So these all movements collectively called what? Growth relevant movements. Understood, children? Next one is growth irrelevant movement. What is mean by growth irrelevant movement? Some specific movements of the plants do not lead to the plant's growth. Movement is there, but that movement is not related to the growth of the plant. Okay, such kind of movements are called what? Growth irrelevant movements. So here example, can you remember? Very good. Mimosa plant. See here, mimosa plant, when we will touch, that leaf will be closed, isn't it, children? See, that movement occurs at the places other than where it has been touched. We can infer that the information about the touch must have been relayed within the plant from one place to another. So when we will touch that one leaflet, the whole part will be closed. So what is the conclusion? That some signal, it will pass from one place to another place. So children, that mimosa plant, when we will touch or when any other stimulus from the surrounding, immediately it will close. After some time it will come in a normal position, isn't it? So here movement is there, but this movement is not related to the growth of the plants. So this kind of movement is called what? Growth irrelevant movement. See here, children. Yes, plants use electrochemical impulses for transfer of information from one place to another. So if we will touch that one small leaflet, then the whole part of the leaf will be closed. So for that, what you will conclude? Yes, that electrochemical impulses are transferred from one place to another place. So plant cells change their shape by increasing or decreasing their water content, and thereby bring about the movement of plants. Okay, so I hope you understood this one. So children, we discussed about coordination in plants. That means growth relevant movement, growth irrelevant movements. Okay, and example also we studied. Children, you have to read your textbook also, and I have given notes also, that also you have to study. Okay, shall I go to next one now? See here, this is touch me not plant. That means mimosa plant. So children, if we touch this only, just hereafter if you see this plant, you will test. Okay, you will check. Just only if you will touch here, that whole part will be closed. Okay, that means this, yes, here that electrochemical impulses are created, and it will transfer from here to this whole part of the leaf. Okay, shall we go to next one now? So children, see here, now we discussed about control and coordination, and coordination in plants. Next one we will see now. Next one is coordination in human being. Okay, children, see here, different processes go on simultaneously in the human body. You know, we are multicellular organisms. At the same time, many systems, that life process, are there in our body, isn't it, children? So that different processes go on simultaneously in the human body. All these processes need to be efficiently and effectively controlled and coordinates. If that proper coordination is there between that processes, then only we can survive smoothly. Okay, so this coordination is very very important for human being and animals also, all animals. Okay, children. So this is done with the help of two system. So children, that coordination, if the proper coordination is there in our body, then only we can survive smoothly. So for this coordination, that it will help what? The two systems are there. Okay, this is done with the help of two systems. Can you say that name? Very good. That is nervous control and chemical control. Okay, we will see now one by one what is meant by nervous control and chemical control. What we discussed, children? Yes, that endocrine glands, that we will see later. Okay, now nervous control, that means here which one is involved? Yes, nervous system. Okay children, see, nervous control is the reason why humans can respond to changes in their surroundings. So children, if any that changes are there in our surrounding, our nerves will collect that information. Okay, so that is the nerves, that is called what? Nervous system. Okay, so nervous control means that is along with these changes in the surrounding, impulses are formed in the human body. So in surrounding, any changes are there, that is here in our body, electrochemical impulses are created. That electrochemical impulses will transmit from one place to another place with the help of nerves. Okay children, see, unicellular organisms, you know what is meant by unicellular organisms. Okay, that body is made up of only one cell. So unicellular organisms such as the amoeba do not have a nervous system that can generate such impulses and responses. So you know that is only one cell in unicellular animals, that is unicellular organisms. So that is only one cell is responsible for all life process. Okay, so however multicellular animals, but multicellular animals, that is like humans, have a separate nervous system to respond to the stimuli. So unicellular organism, that is only one cell is responsible for all life process, but in multicellular organisms, yes, we are having a nervous system to respond to the stimuli. Okay, that only about this nervous system we will see now. Okay children, see here, control and coordination is achieved using a special type of cells called nerve cells or neurons. So you know that, yes, nerve cells, that is the, yes, see here children, what is meant by neurons? That control and coordination is achieved using a special type of cells, that is called what? Neurons. So the structure of neuron, how it will create that electrochemical impulse and how it will transmit from one cell to another cell, one nerve cell to another cell, that all thing we discussed. Anyway, we have to revise one more time also. Okay children, so children, about these neurons and the nervous system we will discuss in next session. Okay children, now see here, for your semester how the question will come, we will see now that small revision. Okay children, see here, choose the correct option, that means choose the correct answer, MCQ. Okay, here you have to give answer. Dash is necessary for the optimal efficiency of the body. Do you know children? Yes, your option is what? Homeostasis, circulation and stimuli. Which one is necessary children? Very good, homeostasis. Okay, so you have to click A option. Next one is, yes, another one more is, the root system of plants responds to stimuli water. These responses are called what? Yes, the root system of plants responds to the stimuli, which stimuli? That water. So that responses are called what? Your options are gravitropic moment, hydrotropic moment and phototropic moment. Which one will come? See here, water. So that is hydrotropic moment. Okay, so gravitropic moment, that is towards the, yes, which stimuli children? Very good, gravitational force. Okay, and phototrophic means which stimuli? Towards the light. So here, towards the water, that is called what? Hydrotropic moment. So this one is the correct answer. Okay children, shall I go to next one now? Next one is true or false. Can you give me the answer? Yes, movement of mimosa plant is an example of the growth relevant moment. Here, true or false? Yes, what is your answer? Very good. This is false. Okay, children, so you have to click in false option. Why? Because the mimosa plant, that moment of mimosa plant, that is growth irrelevant moment, isn't it? But here question is what? This is the example of growth relevant moment. So answer is what? False. Next one is, second question is, see here, humans can respond to changes in their surroundings due to nervous system, due to nervous control. That is, yes, this is correct statement. So your option is what? Correct option is what? True. Okay, children. So I hope you got a clear idea about your, yes, first semester. Children, here brief question and give reason and write short notes. This all question also may come. Okay, so how to study also. Understood, children? At the same time, how to read your textbook. You have to study the notes, which one I have given already. And how to diagram also, how to do practice. Okay, children, I hope you will do this all things. Yes, thank you, children. Sai Ram.